gonna go through the statutory stuff, the vests, and then tell you all about it, and then we'll go through each one that's going. This is a public meeting concerning a proposed zoning bylaw amendments pursuant to section 34 of the Planning Act. We are gonna go through file C-19, our C-319, C-419, C-519, and C-719. Any person or public body is entitled to attend the public meeting and make written or oral submissions in support of or in opposition of any of the proposed zoning bylaw amendments. Written comment should be submitted to the clerk, Joanne Hyde. If a person or public body does not make oral submissions at the public meeting or make written submissions to the township of Southgate before the zoning bylaw is passed, the person or public body is not entitled to appeal the decision of council of the township of Southgate to the local planning appeals tribunal. And in addition, they may not be added as a party to the hearing of an appeal before the local planning appeals tribunal. In the opinion of the board, unless in the opinion of the board, there are reasonable grounds to do so.
Okay. So, first one.
First one is file C-319. The purpose of the bylaw is the purpose of the proposed zoning bylaw amendment application is to consider a change which will allow for a portion of the property to be used as a metal workshop for welding, fabricating, and assembling of parts with office and power room. The shop, including any office and power room, will be 250 meters square. The outside storage area will be 670 meters square. The effect of the proposed zoning bylaw amendment would be to change the zoning symbol on a portion of the property from agriculture A1 zone to agricultural A1 exception to allow for the small-scale secondary use to be permitted on the property. The location of the subject land is legally described as concession to SWTSR Part Lot 221 and Part Lot 222, Geographic Township of Croton. The lands are alternatively described as 752395 Ida Street. The subject land is shown on the key map that was on the reverse side of the notice, and the Township of Southgate official plan designates the subject areas as rural and hazard. Okay. Could I please have confirmation from the clerk that proper notice was given in accordance with the Planning
Act? Mr. Chair, yes, proper notice was given in accordance with the Planning Act. The notice was sent out on March 1st, 2019, and the sign was posted on March 4th, 2019.
Thank you. Now I'll ask the planner, Clint Stradwick, to review correspondence received from commenting agencies.
Thank you, Mayor Woodbury. The first set of agency comments I have here, the Historic Saugeen Métis have no objection. The Public Works Department indicates that a safe access can be provided. It has a rural asphalt along Ida Street. The commercial entrance will require a paved apron, and it is a load-restricted road. Enbridge Gas does not object to the proposed applications. Enbridge Gas reserves the right to amend and remove development conditions. The County of Gray indicate that the proposed metal workshop has been located outside the hazard lands designation. County Trails and Forestry have reviewed the subject application and have no concerns with regard to trails. And county planning staff have no further concerns with the application. The Saugeen Valley Conservation Authority indicates that all of the plan review functions listed in the agreement have been assessed with respect to the application, and the proposed zoning bylaw is acceptable to the SVCA staff. The building department received March 21st. Indicate they have no concerns or objections, but the development will require applicable permits before construction, and a barrier-free washroom will be required with the septic system. And that's all of the agency comments in the file.
Thank you. The building permit one came in after the agenda went out, I take it?
Correct.
Okay. Thank you. Were there any written comments received from members of the public?
None received.
Okay, thank you. Are there any questions from council at this time? Someone? Sure. Barb?
Through the chair. So Clinton, we talked just prior to the meeting, and I noticed that there's a new house across the road on the north side of 22, so the northeast side of Ida and 22. And since they are not shown on any of the maps where they circulated, I think we need to make sure that that new house has been included in its the distance separation from all of that.
I can tell you that the property owner was circulated because we circulate within 120 meters of the property boundary, which would encompass that property.
Okay.
Whether or not the people that are owners or renters, I don't know.
All right. And you had indicated that the area in question that has is highlighted here on the map is 23-ish acres, but that the total farm parcel is larger and encompasses the east side of the rail trail?
That's usually the case with most of the lots along there. It's not always the case, regardless if it is or isn't. This is in a rural designation, and in the rural designation on property less than 50 acres, the maximum shop size is 250 meters squared, and I believe that's what is on the notice. So
yes.
They would comply with that policy.
So it is permitted on something smaller than a 50-acre parcel?
Correct, in
okay.
the rural designation.
Okay.
So whether it is or not, it's kind of neither here nor there.
Okay. I am curious, though, because of the woodlots and the hazard area, the EP area, how much farming could actually be accomplished. And I know there's all kinds of different farming that would qualify for an on-farm diversified use. But it's just the size kind of caught me off guard. We hadn't seen one before like that.
Could you use your microphone, please?
Thank you.
Because it's you that usually tells us.
I know,
so
it was on, though. It was on, wasn't it?
Somebody may have turned it off.
I think somebody's finger on the control mechanism over here keeps turning my microphone off.
Could
for the record.
Could happen.
Since my microphone is on now.
Okay, we'll see.
I think other than those were my questions for this file. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Any further questions from council at this time? No. Okay. Next, I'll ask if the applicant or agent is present, and please state your name, identify yourself and state your name for the record, and would you like to make any representation? Okay, seeing no one forward. Is there anyone present who would like to make a submission in support of this application? Is there anyone present that would like to make a submission in opposition to this? Okay. Any further questions or discussions from council? Okay. Seeing none. That's it. Seeing none. Okay. One more. Go ahead.
With regard to site plan, we talked about it being a gravel portion road on 22, and they are proposing a secondary entrance. We have started the practice of including a requirement to pave from a paved primary road, if that's the entrance that they choose to use. I do note that there are a number of, there's another shop down the way from that. I'll put that out there. It's for consideration with the roads department.
And that might be the requirement that site plan stage, the roads department may say that. You're absolutely right. They have frontage on a paved road, being Ida Street. They're taking it a different frontage on to the side road, or I guess Road 22, which is not paved, and therefore that could mean additional wear and tear. That's not really warranted when they have an entrance already, and therefore there may be some upgrades required.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Seeing no further discussion, I'll declare this portion done, and we will move on to the next, which is...
Can I say something?
Yeah.
I'm the new owner of the property.
Oh, okay. Yeah, could you come up to the microphone
sure.
and identify yourself? Yep.
And turn the microphone on and then just state your name for the record.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Shankar Nagendra. I'm the new owner of the property that you were just talking about on that side.
Okay.
Now, I haven't moved in yet, but I saw on the map, it just showed a vacant land.
Yeah.
So I thought I would be coming. I've never done this before, so I know it from that. My concern is, I know there's a street or a side entrance coming, and it's going to be right opposite the house where I purchased as well. My concern is more with the traffic and what type of construction vehicles will be coming through, and if that will affect the property value. And you know, it's more of a residential area now; it's becoming more of a business. And how big is that going to change?
Mm-hmm. Well, Clint will take down your concerns, and I see he already has been, so it's easy for me to say. I'll get you a second there. So what this will all have, it'll all be looked at during the process of any effects that it'll have. Your comments, Clint will look into and take into consideration. And if this is passed that they can build that there, there'll be a site plan. And what the site plan will deal with where things like the driveway could be, it'll deal with noise, it'll deal with buffering with trees or whatever is the case that way. So it has to go through a couple of hurdles before it gets all the way. And that first one is whether it even passes or not. So Clint, I'll let you in then, Barb.
Yeah. I do want to say one thing, though, because I don't want it to be left hanging there. It was mentioned that it's a residential area. This is absolutely not a residential area. It's a rural area, which is it's open for business for farms and farm shops and whatnot. So it's more broad than that than to say it's strictly for residential. So I don't want there to be that misconception. Residential, quite frankly, is secondary in a rural area because there's so many competing interests with agriculture.
Yeah.
Through the chair, I just wanted to ask the gentleman to, if you could, register your name and contact information
sure.
on that sheet of paper there.
Yeah.
That will help our planner in our
okay, sure,
planning assistant to contact you.
Thank you for coming out.
Mm-hmm.
It's good to have people say things, both both concerns and support for things that are going on. So we do appreciate that.
And welcome.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Next one we're going to do is C-419. Purpose of the zoning bylaw amendment application is to consider a change which will allow for a portion of the property to be used as a metalwork shop for welding, fabricating, and assembly parts with office and power room. Thank you very much. The shop, including any office and power room, will be 633 meters squared, and the outside storage area will be 413 meters squared. The effect of the proposed zoning bylaw amendment would be to change subject property is legally described as concession 10, part lot 34, RP 16R6989, part 1, geographic township of Proton. The lands are alternately described as 1464-84 Southgate Road 14. The subject land is shown on the key map on the reverse side of the notice, and Township of Southgate official plan designates subject lands as agriculture and hazard. May I have confirmation from the clerk that proper notice was given in accordance with the Planning Act?
Through the chair, yes, proper notice was given in accordance with the Planning Act. The notice was sent out on March 1st, and the sign was posted on March 4th.
Thank you. I'll ask our planner, Clint Stredwick, to review any correspondence from commenting agencies.
Thank you again, Mayor Woodbury. The first comments I have are from the County of Grey, and they indicate that provided the MDS can be met, county planning staff have no further concerns. Enbridge Gas has no objection to the proposal. The Historic Saugeen Métis Lands and Resources and Consultation Department have no objection. The Public Works Department indicate if safe access can be provided. It's a rural asphalt road. A road widening is not necessary. A commercial entrance permit will be required with a paved apron. The Saugeen Valley Conservation Authority indicate that all of the plan review functions listed in the agreement have been assessed, and a proposed zoning bylaw amendment is acceptable to the SPCA staff. They do note that there is a potential for significant habitat of endangered and threatened species, and to contact the MNRF to clear that condition. And lastly, on March 21st, Building Department commented, indicating they have no concerns or objections. Will require applicable building permits, and a bare free washroom will be required. That's all of the agency comments.
Thank you. Are there any written comments from members of the public?
None received.
Okay. Any discussion from council? You got a couple questions.
The email address here, NV Wood Machining in Portsmouth, is there an existing machine shop with the owner, and this is going to be a second one in Southgate?
Well, do you have the answer to that? Agent is present. Please identify yourself by stating your name for the record, and would you like to make any representation?
Joseph of business at home.
Oh, okay.
Well, that's the county.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. All right, then. Is there anyone present that would like to make submissions in support of the application? Is there anyone present that would like to make submissions in opposition to the application? Okay, are there any further questions from members of council? Martin?
Yeah, I was wondering about the endangered species, and it says there is the drainage property and there's a water course. Like, how strict is that being looked at? Because there is a big headwater there.
drain, as far as drainage is concerned, that's separate from endangered species. Drainage is covered by the SPCA,
mm-hmm.
in particular, that's their mandate for hazards. The endangered and threatened species is, the only one who can sign off on it is the MNRF.
Okay.
And province, in my opinion, has dropped the ball a little bit on this in that they require basically the applicant to go out and assess themselves when they may not even know what they're looking for. And I applaud anyone who could do it, but I'm not sure I could do it to go out on my property and assess it in a fair manner. But that's the way they've left it, unfortunately.
Mark?
Through the chair, if I may, I might be able to speak a little bit more to that.
Yes, we have the second vice chair of the Southern Valley here, so.
So Clinton is right. There is one person in the MNRF that has oversight for a very broad area. One of the things that also happens is that they say that in general, or the SPCA says that in general. That the SPCA in general will say that, and I'm just going to go to the actual, that the MNRF needs to be consulted for the species at risk, right? And the MNRF will have a better mapping, and because they're saying it could be like within 5 kilometers or, you know, a much greater distance, and they may have narrowed that down and then they will instruct the applicant to do what they need to do to satisfy the MNRF. But you're right, but I think it's because there's just so much area, and a lot of these shops are located within the farm cluster that's
mm-hmm.
already been developed and it's already been addressed.
Go ahead.
Sorry. I wasn't looking for it, it's just that it was in another conversation today, twice today, that I've been suggested that I was correct or right.
Oh,
so
mark it down.
I'm working it down.
Yeah, you're not getting a raise.
Yeah.
Being right twice in the same day is good. Okay, thank you, Barbara. So, seeing no other further questions from council on that, we can move on to the next file. C-519. The purpose of the proposed zoning bylaw amendment application is to consider a change with will allow for additional permitted use. Thanks, guys. Appreciate you being out here. The purpose of the proposed zoning bylaw amendment application is to consider a change which will allow for additional permitted use to an existing metal shop workshop. The additional permitted use is an agricultural mercantile to allow for the sale of items such as, but not limited to, maple syrup, tubing, and belts for machine repair. All other provisions of the bylaw exception will continue to apply. The effect of the proposed zoning bylaw amendment would not change the zoning exception, but would add an additional permitted use to the agriculture exception, A1254. All other provisions of the bylaw shall apply. The subject land is legally described as concessions 16, lot 21 and 22, geographic township of Croton. The lands are alternately described as 245794 Southgate Road 24. The subject land is shown on the key map on the reverse side of the notice, and the Township of Southgate official plan designates the subject lands as agriculture, rural, hazard, and wetland. We have confirmation from the clerk that proper notice was given in accordance with the Planning Act.
To the chair, yes, proper notice was given in accordance with the Planning Act. The notice was sent out on March 1st, and the sign was posted on March 4th.
Thank you. I'll ask our planner, Clint Stredwick, to review any correspondence received from commenting agencies.
Thank you, Mayor Woodbury. The first commenting agency we have is the County of Gray, County Planning Staff. Have no further concerns with the application. The Enbridge Gas Inc. does not object to the proposed application. The Historic Saugeen Métis have no objection or opposition. The Public Works Department indicate it's a rural asphalt standard for the road. Safe access can be provided. The commercial entrance will require a paved apron. The Saugeen Conservation Authority indicate proposed zoning bylaw amendment is acceptable to the SVCA staff, and they also note a significant habitat of threatened and endangered species is somewhere on the property. I would point out that this is sort of a repurposing of an existing building,
mm-hmm.
so the chances of it impacting the significant habitat are nil.
Mm-hmm.
So just a bad comment there. And the last agency comment we have that received on March 21st is the building department, indicating they have no concerns or objections. Any new development will require the applicable permits, and it may require a very big washroom if one is not provided. We also have a letter from the public,
okay.
A letter in support of the application, and it says this is to confirm that as being the neighbor, the immediate neighbor on the west side of the subject property, that we have no concerns and therefore no opposition to the proposed amendment. We wish our neighbor success in their business adventure. David and Pam Barnes.
That's good, thank you. Nothing else from the public?
Not at all.
That's it? Okay, great. Are there any questions from council at this time? Mark?
Yeah, Clinton, you said it's adding on to an existing building. That's not a shop at all. Is it just a barn or is it a metal shop? Or?
Well, there is a shop there, but there's also an agricultural building, a shed, basically, and so they're using part of that for this mercantile business, basically.
Okay.
Repurposing of an existing shed. And they may add on to it a little bit, but it would be significant.
Any further questions from council at this time? All right, seeing none at this point, I'll ask if the applicant or agent is present, please identify yourself by stating your name for the record, and would you like to make any representation?
I'm the owner.
Okay.
Enos Martin.
Yeah.
I'm the owner. I have no woman.
No comments?
No comments.
Okay, well, thank you.
More than you stated, a paved apron,
yes.
Which is already done at this point because of the business we were running already.
Okay.
Great. Well, thank you for being here. Is there anyone that would like to make submission in support of the application? Is there anyone who would like to make submissions in opposition to the application? Any further questions from council?
Mm-hmm.
No?
I'm getting hungry. I can smell lunch.
Oh, okay. Seeing none, I'll call this file closed for the public meeting. Thank you for being here. It's always, in case anything comes up, it's always good to have somebody out. Next, we'll move on to C7-19. The purpose of the proposed zoning bylaw amendment application is to implement a condition of consent to rezone severed lands to recognize a reduced lot frontage as well as any setbacks from existing buildings. The retained parcel will be rezoned to prohibit future residential development. All other provisions of the bylaw exception will continue to apply. The effect of the proposed zoning bylaw is to change the zone symbol on the retained lands from agriculture A1 to agricultural exception A1- to be numbered later. The severed land will be rezoned from agriculture A1 to residential type 6 exception, R6 with other numbers, to be recognized, reduced lot frontage and setbacks for existing structures. All other provisions of the bylaw shall apply. The subject land is legally described as concession 3, lot 35 and 36, and part Township of Southgate official plan designates the subject lands as agriculture, rural, hazardous, and wetland. May I have confirmation from the clerk that this proper notice was given in accordance with the Planning Act?
Through the chair, yes, proper notice was given in accordance with the Planning Act. The notice was sent out on March 1st, and the sign was posted on March 4th.
Thank you. I'll ask our planner, Clint Stredwick, to review correspondence received from commenting agencies.
Okay, thank you, Mayor Woodbury. First, county planning staff indicate they reviewed this proposal under the consent file B518, and their comments are still applicable to the zoning bylaw. County Transportation Services have reviewed the zoning bylaw and they have no concerns. As for the severance, the county will require the 50-foot or daylight triangle on the corner of the county road up, it's up here. There. The daylight shall be beyond the existing county widening and the proposed township widening. Provided the County Transportation Services concerns are addressed and all other comments made in the B518 application, county planning staff have no concerns. Enbridge Gas does not object. The Grand River Conservation Authority has no objection to the proposed zoning bylaw amendment to rezone a portion of the property to prohibit the construction of a dwelling unit to satisfy conditions of consent. I believe there's already a dwelling there, if I'm not mistaken. There's certainly a number of outbuildings there, which is the reason for the somewhat different shape of the parcel. The historic Soggy Métis have no objection or concerns. The public works indicate a safe access can be provided to rural gravel. And that it is a load restricted road. The building department received March 21st, indicate they have no concerns or objections with the application. And that's all the comments that I have.
Thank you. Excuse me, were there any comments from the public?
None received.
Okay, thank you. Any questions from council at this time? Martin?
Yeah, Clint, it says in here from the county that it says the retained parcel will be rezoned to prohibit future residential development. And it was said it was hazard and wetland for a lot of it. Is there a time limit to that? Can that be changed? Once it's severed and written in stone, it can be no more?
A time limit to which part?
Well, it says the condition will be rezoned to prohibit future residential development. Can that be overturned by new owners, per se? It's just a question, right?
But I suppose technically somebody could try and do that.
If they want to spend the money?
If they want to spend the money, at the same time, I would probably, since I'm working on the file, I would know about it, the county would know about it, and they would know the reason why it was put in there in the first place.
Mm-hmm.
As to meet provincial policy, basically. Because the provincial policy said that when you take a severance off in agricultural lands, the practice is to prohibit residential on the remaining portion so that you're not taking any more industrial or agricultural lands, pardon me, out of practice or use.
The other one might be a silly question, but it's mentioning the daylight corner. Why is that? Is that a light post? Or I don't know. You said you mentioned the corner.
Yes.
So
up when you're turning a corner, they basically snip the corner off of these nice square lots like this, and if they have the opportunity, they do it on most of the corners for about 50 feet back, and they do that to allow for turn lanes, for lines of sight, safety reasons. So sometimes they might put a light standard there, what have you. But
okay. No, I just want
to that is.
That's fine. Great.
you through the chair. I also had a question similar to Councillor Shipton, but to just take it a little bit further, thank you for the question and the answer. Is it registered on title? Because, I mean, the prohibition for development, the residential development, I guess where the question lies is that lots change hands. It may get sold to, you know, another farmer down the road. Is it registered on title so that it shows up in a title?
It's in the zoning bylaw. So when a lawyer does their due diligence and requests a zoning compliance letter, it will show up at that.
And that's a standard practice, a zoning compliance letter?
Yes.
Oh, good. Thank you.
Seeing nothing else from council at this moment, I'll ask if the applicant or agent is present, and please identify yourself by stating your name for the record, and would you like to make any representation?
Pete Schill, I'm the owner of the said property there. I have no concerns.
Okay, thank you. Is there anyone